So let's have a quick recall of, you know, what dimensions are. Yesterday we have studied this, but still we will have a quick recall of, you know, what dimensions are, so that slowly we push into the complex things. Okay. So as defined earlier, you know, the dimensions of physical quantity, basically they are the powers to which the fundamental units must be raised in order to obtain the unit of a given physical quantity. That means we are going to use fundamental units and we are going to, you know, put some powers to those fundamental units to get a unit of any other physical quantity, and then the arrangement will be called as dimension. So let's talk about speed here. Speed is distance upon time. Okay. So let's see how the dimensional equation for speed would be. Now speed, say speed is the quantity which depends on distance and time. So first of all, whenever you put the dimension, you'll have to put an arrangement like this, LMT, or you also put it as MLT, one and the same. L will stand for length, M will stand for the mass, and T stands for the time. Okay, friends. Again, I say the dimension is an arrangement like this in a bracket, where you put it as LMT. Or MLT, one and the same. L represents length, M represents mass, and T represents time. So far as speed is concerned, you know, there is nothing related to mass in the numerator and denominator. So I have kept mass raised to zero. There is something related to length in the numerator, that to one time. Therefore, I have placed L raised to plus one. There is something related to time in the denominator, and that to one time. So I have placed T raised to minus one. So L raised to one, M raised to zero, and T raised to minus one will stand as dimensions for the quantity like speed and velocity. This is how you are going to place dimensions for different quantities. This is something which we have seen yesterday. We are having a quick revision of it, so that slowly we move into the complex situations. Okay. Hopefully, all those who are not there, take a quick note of that. Okay. Before I show you a different slide. Yeah. So, in our table, yesterday we have seen the dimension for speed. Just now we have derived it with the help of either with the help of a formula or with the help of a unit. The unit, as I said yesterday, here it should be meter per second. Just now we have derived the dimension for speed, and what was it? L raised to 1, M raised to 0, T raised to minus 1. An important thing, linear momentum, how we work out the dimensions for linear momentum, okay? So we all know linear momentum is a product of mass and velocity. Okay, so velocity ka dimensions we have worked out, and the dimensions for mass would be L0, M1, T0. So you can see the unit can also give you the dimension. Kg means something related to mass, so M raised to 1. Meter means something related to length, so L raised to 1. Second means something related to time, so S raised to minus 2, T raised to minus 2. So the dimensions for linear momentum would be L raised to 1, M raised to 1, and T raised to minus. It should be minus 1, in fact. It should not be minus 2, because the unit for velocity is meter per second. So it should be second raised to minus 1. Here it's wrongly mentioned. Okay, so it will be T raised to minus 1. Okay. Important thing, acceleration. Now acceleration is defined as change in velocity per unit time, or the unit for acceleration will be meter per second square. So from the unit also you can put the dimension. Length raised to 1 because meter is 1. T raised to minus 2 because S raised to minus 2 over there. But nothing related to mass, so M raised to 0. So L raised to 1, M raised to 0, and T raised to minus 2 are the dimensions for acceleration. Hopefully things are pretty clear till here. Anybody of you can respond, say you are okay with it, then we move towards the complicated situations.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, great, great, great. Okay. important thing. Let's talk about force. Okay, force ka dimension we have to find out, and the formula for force is mass into acceleration. The unit is Newton. So from unit you cannot find out the dimension, but then you have the two quantities getting multiplied over here in formula. You will use that. So mass ka dimension kya ho jayega? L0 M1 T0. This is the dimension for mass. Multiplied by dimension for acceleration. Just now you have derived the dimension. What were the dimensions? M. Yeah, it was L raised to 1, M raised to 0, and T raised to minus 2. Now you add corresponding powers, you will get the dimensions for force as L raised to 1, M raised to, yes, anybody of you can respond, L raised to 1, M raised to, yeah, anyone you, of you can say, what would be the dimension for force? M raised to 1, right? Because there is mass involved, right? So mass M raised to 1. There is length also involved in acceleration. So L raised to 1 and T raised to minus 2 are the dimensions for force. All right. So the same dimensions, I will place it in a different way basically. Just give me a moment till the time I show you a different screen now. Just give me a moment. Now we will start working on this. Okay. Yeah, friends. So let's start working on this. Okay, so we are supposed to find out dimensions for force. Just now we have found out the dimensions for force. And what were the dimensions for force? Come on, M raised to 1, L raised to 1, T raised to minus 2. It could have been other way around also, L1, M1, T raised to minus 2. You can change the order, no issues. But as of now, you all know how we derived the dimensions for force. Okay, so the dimension for force were M raised to 1, L raised to 1, T raised to minus 2. So we will change the order now. We will represent the mass first, then the length, and then the time. Okay, this is how we would represent it for the dimension. Let's talk about power. Yesterday itself, we have derived the dimensions for power. And power is work done upon time, right? So what were the dimensions for power? It's not force, okay, it's power. The second is regarding power. So can anybody tell me what were the dimensions for power yesterday?
So?
Yes.
May I?
Yes, yeah, you can.
L raised to 1.
L will be? Yeah. You just increase the speed of your microphone, volume of microphone, so that you are clearly heard.
It's full, sir.
Yeah, somebody has kept the... okay, fine. Okay, so for power, it will be work done divided by time. Okay, so when you do it, work done divided by time, you will get the dimensions as M1, L1, T raised to minus 3. You can check this. Second dimensions are for power. Okay. Now the complex things come into picture. Okay, as of now, till power, we were just using three fundamental quantities. M standing for length, M standing for mass, L standing for length, and T standing for time here in this case. Now, if we come across the quantities like electric potential, so electric potential, we'll have to introduce one more fundamental quantity. And if you remember, what was the fundamental quantity associated with current electricity? Electric current. Out of those seven quantities, one quantity was electric current. Do you all remember that? Yeah, do you all remember that? One of the quantity was electric current, friends?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now, instead of three representations in the bracket, we will have four representation, okay? MLT would be represented as it is. There would be one more extra term coming into picture, and that is of current I. Okay, so let's see how it works. So we'll just check how it works, friend. Okay, so let's go ahead. So when we talk about electric potential, okay, now we are moving towards, you know, little bit complex situations, you can see. So electric potential, how do we define electric potential, friends? You might have studied electric potential in 10th standard. Okay, work done in bringing unit positive charge. Okay, so work done in bringing charge from infinity to a particular point in an electric field is electric potential. So in terms of formula, if you say electric potential will be given as work done divided by charge. So electric potential ka jo formula hai wo hai work done divided by charge. Now we know the dimensions for work done. What were the dimensions for work done? M1, yeah, L2 T raised to minus 2, if you all remember. Force into displacement. Force into displacement matlab is dimension ko displacement ke saath add karenge na. So L raised to 1 plus 1 ho jayega. That's the only thing for work done. Okay. So for work done, you can see the dimensions will be M1 L2 T raised to minus 2. You can say work done can be represented as force into displacement divided by the charge. So now you have three quantities involved in the formula. One is force, second is displacement, and the third one is charge. So charge can be written as, how do you represent current? How do you define electric current? Can anybody tell me how we define electric current? Ananya, how do we define electric current?
Sir, I think the amount of charge flowing through a unit area.
Per unit time, okay? You are right, okay. Till per unit time. So yes, the rate of flow of charge or amount of charge per unit time is current. So obviously current charge will be, so if I is Q upon T, so Q will be represented as I into T, where I stands for current and T stands for time. So now there are four quantities involved for finding out the dimensions for electric potential. That's where the complex situation comes into picture. Okay, friends? So idhar tak pahunchna hoga aapko sabse pehle. We started with the basic definition of electric potential. What was it? Work done in bringing charge from infinity to a particular point in electric field. This work done was further substituted as force into displacement, and charge as per definition was current multiplied by time, because current is charge divided by time. So charge can be written as current multiplied by time. So now we have to represent all these in fundamental quantity terms. So let's see how we do it. Okay, yeah, so if you observe this step, very crucial step, friends, force over here can be represented as M raised to 1, L raised to 1, T raised to minus 2. So I'm just placing the dimension for force. Displacement, I will place the dimensions as something related to length. So M raised to 0, nothing related to mass. So M raised to 0, something related to length, that too in the numerator. So L raised to 1, nothing related to time. So T raised to 0. So for displacement, the dimensions are M raised to 0, L raised to 1, and T raised to 0. Divided by, now comes the quantity current. So current, you can put it as nothing related to mass, so M raised to 0, nothing related to length, nothing related to time, so M0, L0, T0, but something related to current, and that too one time, so I raised to 1. So here we introduce the fourth parameter, current. So I raised to 1 in that dimension, okay, remember. Then when we talk about time, there is nothing related to length, mass, and current. Only related to time, so everything will be 0 except time. Time will be 1. Now you can see there is a multiplication going on between the two quantities in the numerator and two quantities in the denominator. So correspondingly, for multiplication, you will add the corresponding powers. Now when I say corresponding powers, that means you will add the powers of mass to mass, length to length, time to time, and current to current. Okay, let's see. Let's move on. So when you talk about numerator, you can see for mass it will be m raised to 1 plus 0. So m raised to 1, you can see over here. Similarly, for length it will be 1 plus 1. You can check over here, check the arrow. 1 plus 1 will give you l raised to 2 over here. Similarly, for time you can see t raised to minus 2 plus 0. So it will give you minus 2 plus 0 is minus 2. This was about the numerator. Similarly, follow the same procedure for the denominator. Now for denominator, you can see m raised to 0 plus 0 will be 0. Similarly, l raised to 0 plus 0 will be 0. T raised to 0 plus 1, you can see t raised to 0 plus 1 will give you t raised to 1. And I raised to 1 plus 0 will give you I raised to 1 over here. So these are the dimensions for the denominator. Now you have two quantities, one in the numerator and other in the denominator. The very next procedure is to subtract the corresponding powers from numerator and denominator basically. That means mass ka power will be subtracted from mass, length ka powers will be subtracted from length, and so on. So let's see. Let's move right towards the last step. If you observe, can check m raised to 1 minus 0 is 1. L raised to 2 minus 0 is 2. T raised to minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3. And current, there was no current, so I was 0. So 0 minus 1 will be minus 1. So the dimensions for electric potential would be m raised to 1, l raised to 2, t raised to minus 3, and I raised to minus 1. So here we have introduced one more quantity, and that is the current over here. So these were the dimensions for electric potential. So according to our slide, we have worked out the dimensions for force. I told you how to work it out for power. Here you just replace this word by the word power. Rate at which work is done or work done per unit time, you can get these dimensions. Electric potential, we defined it first, then we arranged it, and after arrangement we worked out the dimension. Okay, so we have worked out an interesting dimension over here, electric potential. Okay, hopefully you have understood how to work out the dimensions for electric potential. You people can respond if you have understood this or not. You can unmute and speak.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so you understood this procedure. Hopefully this is not complicated for you people.
Okay. No, not at all, sir.
You have understood, right? Okay, great. So now if these things are easy for you, it will be really easy for you to solve further examples also. Let's talk about the fourth quantity, and that is resistance. Now, whenever we talk about resistance, obviously the first thing which comes in our mind is Ohm's law. Can anybody tell me regarding Ohm's law? Is anybody aware of Ohm's law? Yeah, anybody from your side, you can unmute, increase the volume and speak. So resistance is given by V by I, or V is equal to IR. You all remember that? V equal to IR. Do you all remember that? Have you studied it in 10th standard? Ananya?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So V is equal to IR. So this is Ohm's law, right? So Ohm's law gives you this formula. And with the help of this formula, we will, you know, find out the dimensions for the resistance. So from this, you very well know V stands for electric potential, I stands for current, and R stands for the resistance, friend. So if that is the case, then the resistance, if you shuffle this equation in terms of resistance, then that equation would appear to be, you know, V divided by I, where V stands for electric potential and I stands for current. So there are two physical quantities involved over here, electric potential and current. and what's going on between the two quantities? There is a division going on between the two quantities. So first I will try to place the dimension for V, then I will place the dimension for I, and then corresponding powers will be subtracted because the division is on. Okay, let's see. So you can see what are the dimensions for electric potential? M raised to 1, L raised to 2, isn't it? And T raised to minus 3, and I raised to, here we have derived it as minus 1. Here wrongly it has been written as 1. So you also consider this as minus 1, okay? There is a typological error over here. Here you should consider it as minus 1, I raised to minus 1. So these are the dimensions for the quantity in the numerator. Let's talk about the denominator. The denominator, what it says, only current, so nothing related to mass, so m raised to 0, nothing related to length, so length raised to 0, nothing related to time, so time raised to 0, but something related to current, so current raised to 1. Here the current was minus 1, remember, that's the error over here, okay, you have to correct it. I raised to minus 1, because here this equation tells you why it is minus 1. How we got it as minus 1. So I will be minus 1, I raised to minus 1 over here. Here I raised to 1. Now corresponding powers are to be, you know, subtracted. Why? Because we are dividing one quantity by other. So when you subtract it, let's see what you get. So for mass, it will be 1 minus 0, 1. For length, it will be 2 minus 0, 2. For time, it will be minus 3, minus 0, minus 3. And for current, minus 1. It's not 1, it's minus 1 over here. So minus 1, minus 1 will give you minus 2 if you know you are okay with the number line. So the dimensions for resistance then would be M raised to 1, L raised to 2, T raised to minus 3, and I raised to minus 2. The only correction over here is instead of 1, it should be minus 1. Hopefully, you have understood how to work out the dimension for resistance, friends. Yes, Reva, did you understand this?
Yes, sir, for sure.
Okay. So, you just take a quick note of this, a screenshot of this before we move ahead. Isme ye slide mein do corrections hai, wo dhyan mein rakho. Idhar jo force likha hai, uske jagah power likhna hai aapko. Secondly, there is a correction. Either minus 1 aya tha, to idhar bhi minus 1 lena chahiye. Okay, that's the correction. Final answer is correct, but here there is a typological error. So you just, you know, think about that correction whenever you study. So take a screenshot of this before we move ahead towards the next two types of quantities. Okay. So the very next quantity, you can see, they talk about refractive index. Then permittivity is the next quantity which you would be studying, or you would be understanding it for the first time. Therefore, it becomes complicated. Then similarly, we will try to study permeability. Okay, this is also something which you would be studying it for the first time. So hopefully you have taken the screenshot of this. Okay, so tell me one thing. Refractive index is something which you come across laws of refraction. Snell's law. Can anybody tell me what is Snell's law? Yeah, anybody from your side? Gargi, Maitri, or Reva, Ananya, anybody can speak. So what is Snell's law saying? Because you get the concept of refractive index from the laws of refraction, if you all remember. Do you all agree with what I am saying? Let it be an interactive session.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So refractive index jo hai, you place it as the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the ratio of sine of angle of refraction. That is sine I upon sine R. Both I and R, they are angle of incidence and refraction. So therefore, there is no dimension, you can see. So no dimension over here. Yeah. for angle of incidence, angle of refraction. So the no dimension in the numerator, no dimension in the denominator. So refractive index is a dimensionless quantity, friend. Refractive index will be a dimensionless quantity. All right. Okay, let's see. Permittivity now. This is something very new to you people. Okay, what is permittivity? Let's understand permittivity. Permittivity is the permission given by the medium for electric field to pass through it. It's just like a concept of visa. Okay, visa means the permission given by that country for somebody from the other country to enter. Isn't it? So permittivity is the permission given by medium for electric field to enter that particular medium. And it is given by Coulomb's law actually. You will be studying this law in details in the later stages. Okay. So uska jo formula hai wo aapko main bata deta hu. It is given as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. So 4 pi, they are constant, and this term is a Greek notation. And we call this as epsilon, E-P-S-I-L-O-N, epsilon naught. Epsilon naught stands for permittivity. So it's the notation for permittivity, okay? Permittivity means permission given by the medium for electric field. Q1 and Q2 are the charges, magnitude of charges. And R is the distance between the two charges. And we know the dimension for force. We know the dimension for charges. We know the dimension for R square. So we are supposed to find out the dimension for permittivity. Again, I repeat, what is permittivity? Permittivity is the permission given by the medium for electric field to pass through it. So let's shuffle it in terms of epsilon. When you shuffle it in terms of epsilon, you get a formula like 1 upon 4 pi. Okay, so you take epsilon over here. So F will come down. So Q1, Q2 will remain as it is. R square ke nazdik kya jayega, F will come down. So F over here. So 1 upon 4 pi is a constant. It's not a quantity. So the quantities which will decide the dimensions for permittivity, they are the charges Q1, Q2, the force and the distance square. So these are the quantities which will decide the dimensions for permittivity, friends. Let's go ahead and derive the dimensions for permittivity. Okay, so let's put it this way. 1 upon 4 pi is a constant and hence it is dimensionless. So this entire thing is dimensionless. Okay. Yeah. Now, epsilon can be written as Q1. Q1 is the charge 1. It can be written as current into time. So current 1 into time. Similarly, charge 2 can be represented as current into time for the second case. Niche to hai denominator mein, you can see it is F multiplied by R square. So now these quantities are involved to get the dimension of epsilon naught. And now what this epsilon naught is, this is the permittivity, concept of permittivity. Remember this, very important, friends. Now let's put the dimensions in for the numerator as well as denominator before we find out the resultant dimensions. Okay. So let's put it. So can I say for current and time for the first case, I will place it as M0, L0, because T is there, T raised to 1. And current is there for one time, so it is I raised to 1. Whatever is true for Q1 will be true for Q2 also, because it's also the charge. So the dimensions would be M0, L0, T raised to 1 and I raised to 1. Let's talk about denominator. Denominator, the first quantity involved is the force. So when we talk about force, we have already derived the dimensions for force. And what were the dimensions for force? M1. L1, P minus 2, and I raised to 0, obviously, if you put I over here. The next quantity is R square, that is distance square. So nothing related to mass, so M raised to 0. Something related to length, that to 2 times, so L raised to 2. Nothing related to time, so T raised to 0. So So for all the four quantities, two in the numerator and two in the denominator, I have placed the dimensions. So the numerator quantities are getting multiplied. Denominator is also getting multiplied. So first we will work out numerator and denominator, and then subsequently we will subtract numerator from denominator. Okay, so let's go ahead. So when you talk about these quantities, look here. M0, L0 gets added to 0 and 0. So this will be M0, L0. Let's talk about T. So T, it is 1 plus 1. In the denominator, you can see T raised to 2. Similarly, for current, it is 1 plus 1. So you get in the numerator as current raised to plus 2. Let's talk about the denominator, how you get this value. So M raised to 1 plus 0, you get M raised to 1. L raised to 1 plus 2, so that is L raised to 3, you can see. And T, when you talk about time in the denominator, it will be minus 2 plus 0. So minus 2 plus 0 is minus 2, you can see. Now you have the dimensions in the numerator as well as the denominator. Corresponding powers has to be subtracted because division is going on. So M ka kya ho jayega? Dekho, 0 minus 1 will give you M raised to minus 1, you can see. Similarly for L, 0 minus 3 will give you L raised to minus 3. For time, it is 2 minus minus 4. So 2 minus minus 4 will give you T raised to 4. Current, 2 minus 0, there is nothing means 0. 2 minus 0 is 2. So you get the dimensions for permittivity as M raised to minus 1, L raised to minus 3, T raised to 4, and I raised to 2. This is how you derive the dimensions for permittivity. And what is permittivity, friends? Again, I say, is the permission given by the medium for electric field to pass through it. This is how you derive the dimensions for permittivity. So did you all understand it? You can respond. You can just give me the feedback. Unmute and give me the feedback so that we move ahead towards the last one for the day.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so you can see, if you logically try to remember all this, the complicated things become easier. The next dimension is permeability. So it's not permittivity, okay? Wrongly written. Permittivity is repeated over here. This was permittivity. Here I'm saying permeability, okay? So you make that correction. Permeability, the spelling goes P-E-R-M-E-A, okay? B-I-L-I-T-Y, permeability. So permeability is related to magnetism. You can see, okay? Permeability is related to magnetism, friends. And permittivity is related to, okay, repeat the name of the symbol. Okay, yeah, I will. So Anushka, the symbol is epsilon naught. Epsilon. This symbol is epsilon. E-P-S-I-L-O-N. Epsilon. This is a Greek notation. Okay, so permittivity, and the definition for permittivity will be, okay, the definition of permittivity would be, you know, the permission given by the medium for the electric field to pass through it. But unlike permittivity, we have one more concept called as permeability. Idhar ye spelling wrong hua hai. So aapko main spelling bata raha hun. P-E-R-M-E-A-V-I-L-I-T-Y. Permittivity is related to electric field, whereas permeability is related to magnetic field, friends. Just like permittivity is the permission for electric field to pass through it, permeability is the permission for magnetic field to pass through a medium. Sorry, that's how you define permeability. And according to Coulomb's law of magnetism, this permeability will be given as mu naught upon 4 pi m1 m2, okay, you can see m1 m2 upon r square, where mu naught stands for permeability. This notation is mu, okay. Again, it's a Greek notation for permeability. The same notation is being used for refractive index also, but that is in optics. In magnetism, mu is used for permeability. Okay, 4 pi is constant. So let's talk about mu. So force, shuffle everything in terms of mu. So you can shuffle this as, you know, mu naught will be 4 pi f into r square upon m1 into m2. Okay, now remember this, this small m is not mass or length. This is pole strength, all right? So m1 is also pole strength of north pole and m2 is the pole strength of south pole. So whatever the dimensions are for north pole, pole strength, and for the south pole, it will get squared. Okay, so that's why you can see the dimension for pole strength is L1, I1, M0, T0, L1, I1, and why square of this? Because pole strength multiplied by pole strength will give you pole strength square. So square. So we have worked out the denominator first over here. Now in the numerator, you have force. You know the dimensions of force. What are the dimensions of force? M1, L1, T raised to minus 2. R square. R square means distance. Distance square. So L raised to 2. There is nothing related to mass. So M0. Nothing related to time. So T0. So I have placed the dimensions in the numerator and the denominator. You take a screenshot of this before I start simplifying things. Now we will work out the numerator first. The corresponding powers are to be added. Okay. So when we add the corresponding powers, you can see, you can just see m raised to 1 plus 0 minus 0 is 1. L raised to 1 plus 2, that is 3, minus 1. So 3, you can see 1 plus 2, 3, 3 minus 1. Okay. So here, instead of 1, it will be 2, right? Because 2 multiplied by 1 will be 2 over here in the denominator. So again, think about L. L will be 1 plus 2, 3 minus 2. So L raised to 1, you can see. L raised to 1. Let's talk about time. T raised to minus 2 plus 0 minus 0. Because 0 se 2 ko multiply bhi kiya to bhi wo 0 hone wala hai. So minus 2 plus 0 minus 0 is minus 2. So T raised to minus 2. Finally, current. So there is no current over here. No current representation here. So 0 plus 0 minus, this is not 1, it has to be squared, so 2. So 0 minus 2 will give you minus 2. So I raised to minus 2. This is how you get the dimensions for permeability, friends. And the dimensions are m raised to 1, l raised to 1, t raised to minus 2, I raised to minus 2. You have to understand one thing, m1 and m2 are not the masses over here. They are the pole strengths, and pole strength's unit is ampere meter. So ampere stands for current, meter stands for length. So ampere meter is the unit for pole strength. Okay, remember that. But because there is a multiplication between the two similar quantities, you know, we have squared it. Hopefully you understood how to work out the dimensions for permeability. Here you have to change the word. Okay, you have to call it as permeability. So friends, are you comfortable in deriving the dimensions now? You can just give me the feedback, because this is something complicated which we have seen.
Yes, sir.
Do you really find it complicated or interesting?
Interesting.
Exactly. Little bit complicated.
Sorry, Reva?
Little bit complicated.
Yeah, but logically if you know, go with this, things will become easier. Ye sabse highest level maine aapko bataya hai. All right. इसमें भी कुछ doubts रहे, individually you can always, you know, talk to me regarding it. Individually you can always